Here we got an example of edge stressing. Let's see the components here and how do they fit together. This one here, the very first one, is obviously your anchor. Next is recess. So it's a plastic form, which is actually temporary. Gets placed here, and later after we pour the concrete and remove the edge board, we're gonna slide it out. And we got anchor head or banana, which gets in place before stressing and eventually wedges. So let's look at this together one by one. Imagine this is your concrete pour. You place this inside your slab, and this is going to be your edge of the slab. So your edge board will be sitting right here. So this will be buried inside concrete, dead end. So you pour the concrete, you wait for 24 hours, next day, you come and do initial. Initial means that you apply 25% of your tendon capacity. For example, if you got 4 strands, you stress only one of them. So you may say, why do we do that? That's because post-tension slabs are minimally reinforced. And if you don't have any means of controlling shrinkage cracks, it will simply crack the next day. So that little stressing that you apply the next day is simply to control shrinkage cracks. And later in days 3-4, you will come back and do full stress. So, but it's still necessary to do it in 2 stages. As I said, it's for controlling the shrinkage cracks. So next day you come back, so you gotta take your edge board off, you take it off, and then you slide out this recess. See that? So it comes out completely. So here is a plastic one, but sometimes some of them are made of foam. So this is temporary anyway, just to give us a nice area and access for our jack so we can fit these to our jack so we can pull them out. That's really necessary. So I'll put this aside. Next is placing your anchor head or banana. Looks like banana, a bit big one. So let's go. So here you see I've got 5 holes, actually allowing for 5 strands to go inside. Sometimes we also have a smaller version which only lasts for 3 strands. Again, as I said, the monostrand system is mostly used with 3 strands and up to 5 strands. That's why you get, you know, even the anchor head suitable for 3 strands and obviously here for 5 strands. So let's fit this in. See that? So it comes and nicely sits right against your anchor. So this anchor head is literally touching your anchor. So later, once you pull these strands, obviously it'll be fully locked in and it's transferring all the load by bearing against the anchor. So next is fitting this into your jack. Imagine my hand is jack. So this is the jack, feeds in, and we're going to put these 2 wedges at 2 sides of this hole. So we're gonna fit this in again. Maybe I'll do it for the first one, it's easier to see. And as the jack pulls this strand, these 2 wedges goes inside the anchor head, see that? So by doing that, they're locking the strand force to the anchor. So they won't be obviously coming out because it's like a wedge, right? So it gets locked in inside. So as long as that force is present there, that wedge won't come out. Unless the wedge fails or for some reason the other end fails. Actually, these are the common failures of post-tensioning system that we could experience. So we gotta be mindful of them. So doing that, the force simply gets transferred from the anchor head to the anchor. An anchor is going to transfer the load to the concrete by means of these ribs. See these ribs? So you got 3 ribs. So distributing load in 3 different levels. And again, you see the application of helix? Because imagine you got, you know, the compression strips going all around this anchor. It says 360, right? It's not just 2D. So that's why you have this all around it. So this is going into compression. So if there is no helix here, it wants to, you know, burst like that, open up. So if I do it the other angle, so think about it like this. It's like I'm pushing down my hands, and my toes tend to go away from each other. So the helix or spiral prevents that, controls that bursting or opening up. So that's why it's important that we get it placed right at the anchor. If it sits somewhere here, or sometimes it's completely squashed up, you know. So that's again useless. So it's important that it gets installed in the right place and correctly, as I just explained. So that's pretty much it. So that's how the whole system works. So we're going to stress it, and eventually this is going to work the way we want it.